In this lesson, we will discuss how to find pi groups using Ipsen's method for dimensional analysis problems. In previous videos, we discussed how to find a valid set of pi groups using the method of repeating variables. The method of repeating variables is highly structured, and if you follow all the steps correctly, you're guaranteed to find a valid set of pi groups. But applying the method of repeating variables can sometimes be a bit long and tedious when there are many variables. An alternative method for finding a valid set of pi groups is Ipsen's method, which can be broken down into four steps. The first two steps are the same as the method of repeating variables. We list the functional relationship between all the relevant variables. Then we list the basic dimensions of each variable. In Ipsen's method, you can use either the FLT or MLT systems. The third step consists of eliminating the dimensions of all variables through multiplication or division of the independent variables. Finally, once a set of pi groups is obtained, you should double-check that the pi groups are indeed dimensionless. To demonstrate how Ipsen's method works, we will revisit a system discussed several times in previous videos where a smooth-walled pipe experiences steady, incompressible, isothermal, fully developed turbulent flow. Recall that the pressure drop per length of pipe, delta PL, is some function of the flow speed V, pipe diameter D, fluid density rho, and the fluid's absolute viscosity, mu. Writing out this functional relationship is step one. In step two, we list the basic dimensions of each variable in the FLT or MLT dimensional system. And here we will arbitrarily select the MLT system. In the MLT system, delta PL has dimensions of mass, length to the negative 2, time to the negative 2. Speed V has dimensions of length per time. Diameter D has dimensions of length. Density rho has dimensions of mass per length cubed. And absolute viscosity mu has dimensions of mass per length per time. Let's eliminate mass from all the variables. We do this by selecting an independent variable that contains mass, which means we can either select rho or mu. Let's select rho. We multiply or divide all of the variables by rho in such a way that mass will be eliminated from every variable. Notice that delta PL, rho, and mu all have mass to the first power. So we can divide those three variables by rho to eliminate mass. V and D do not contain mass, so we leave those variables alone. All of the resulting quantities do not have mass as a dimension. The dimensions of delta PL over rho are length per time squared. The dimensions of V are length per time. The dimensions of D are length. Rho has been eliminated and we no longer need to consider it. And mu over rho has dimensions of length squared per time. Now let's eliminate time from the four remaining quantities. We do this by selecting an item on the right side of the equation that contains time, such as the flow speed V. We multiply or divide the four remaining quantities by V in such a way that time will be eliminated. V has time to the negative 1, and delta PL over rho has time to the negative 2. So we can divide delta PL over rho by V squared to eliminate time. We can divide V by itself to eliminate time. D does not contain time, so we leave it alone. And mu over rho has time to the negative 1, so we divide this quantity by V to eliminate time. All of the remaining items do not have time as a dimension. The dimensions of delta PL over rho V squared are length to the negative 1. V has been eliminated and we no longer need to consider it. D has dimensions of length. And the dimensions of mu over rho v are length. Let's move our results to the top of the screen and continue. The last dimension we need to eliminate is length. We do this by selecting an item on the right side of the equation that contains length, such as diameter d, and multiply or divide the three remaining items by d in such a way that length will be eliminated from every item. We multiply delta PL over rho V squared by D, we divide D by itself, and we divide mu over rho V by D in order to eliminate length. D has been eliminated, and we no longer need to consider it. The remaining two groups of variables are both dimensionless and are a valid set of pi groups. Now let's write the functional relationship for these pi groups. Delta PLD over rho v squared is some function phi of mu over rho vd, which is the reciprocal of the Reynolds number. As mentioned in a prior video, we have the freedom to use the pi groups as shown on the screen or their reciprocal. So this relationship would typically be expressed as delta PLD over rho v squared is some function phi of the Reynolds number. And notice this is the same result we obtained using the method of repeating variables. At this point, you should verify that all pi groups are dimensionless, but we will skip that step here. It should be noted that in the uncommon situation where the number of basic dimensions differs in the FLT and MLT systems, Ipsen's method will still produce the correct number of pi groups regardless of which dimensional system you use.